Yeah, so today I'm working on the maze generator. Yeah. Think it might just be us. Hundred percent coverage. What's up, Boogie? Arcane, the bit shifting's all taken care of. So yeah, today I'm on to doing something else, but related to the same thing. Yo, you guys, I hope the internet's okay today. See, have I got any dropped frames yet? Looks like whoa, look at that. Whoa, we're streaming longer than we're recording. That's amazing. So what I'm working on today is like the overworld looks like this. Yeah, Bill Gates. Which kind of gates? These gates? Yeah, so the gates are all implemented in the game, right? So yesterday I was working on, the whole overworld and or, basically placing gates next to, like, for example, if there was a level right there, there would be a gate on this screen going to the west. Like, so there'd be a gate like right there that prevents the player from accessing this area if they don't have the traversal item or whatever. So most of the code to do that in the game is finished, but now I've got something a little higher scope, a little bit. I've been wanting to do this for a long time, and I'm really excited to be finally doing this. But taking it so all these areas, for example, this green area is one section of the overworld. The dark green area is another section. The sand and the mountains are also sections. And so it's going to generate its own maze inside each one of these. So the maze will be contained inside here. There will be like perhaps three or four different gates on the way to get out of the green area and into the dark green area. Same thing with going with the sand. There might be like two exits, like one exit there and one there or something to get into this area. But other than that, this maze is self-contained. Same thing for the mountains. So this has actually been a lot of work. I've been coding since yesterday's stream just on this. Like right after the stream, I started this whole code, and this is a lot of code to do this, but it's coming along. So yeah, and the maze generator is pretty cool because if I simply place an exit here or a gate there or an opening, sorry, that's just an opening. If I open up the maze right there and then block off the maze here, 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 the maze will automatically generate inside here. And then it'll connect to this one single opening, and then it'll go into there and there and there. And as long as I had placed a gate there, then it's good to go. What's up, PETA? Welcome to the stream, man. How you doing today, PETA? Bellazio. So this is a lot of code, and it might take me the rest of the whole day just to finish this. But I'm actually getting pretty close. I've got it now where it's sorting out a vector and showing all the possible positions. So it's like shows, for example, this is considered an edge, that's considered an edge, that's an edge, these are edges. It knows where all the edges are, and it can place gates. It can choose like, okay, I want to have a gate there and a gate there and a gate there. But now I'm working on the placing gates code again. I've rewritten this code like two or three times so far. Bellazio, so where I'm at in the code right now for doing that is this find edges function. This is cool. This find edges function works, and it works great, but I do this twice. There's two functions for finding edges, and one of them is just simply finding the edges squared. The other one is finding the edges, and I want to simplify that into just one method if possible, where it just finds all the edges squared, and then the find edges function is a little smarter. Bars of noise. Oh, I don't know. Hey, wait, was it my game show? It could be. I've been having crazy internet here. Nope. Oh, it's all right. Except that it has a lot of drop frames. Huh. Okay, so right now, yeah, it pushes every edge back into this into a vector where it lists all the possible edges. I'm thinking I might need to actually create a small structure which can hold. Basically, the x2, the y2, and the direction. That would give me enough information to. Yeah, let's do that. There needs to be a structure called. Gate. Sort of. Not really. It's more of an edge. And it needs to have an X2, a Y2, and a direction. And easy to construct. All right, there. So now we've got the edge type. Now find edges squared. Going to rewrite this whole function here, find edges squared. In fact, the places where I am, I'm using find edges squared right now, I'm just going to comment them out. So there's just no, I'm not even worried about it right now. And then, oops. Right, so find edges squared takes, yeah, it's gonna fill up a V, oh. Yeah, this might be better to use a vector 3 actually for all these. And push back instead the XY quadrant. Yeah, XY quadrant would be better. So V3I. This is kind of how this whole bit of code has been going the whole time I've been writing it. I'm like, wait, there's a simpler way to do that. There's a simpler way to do that. And that's actually turning out to be a good thing because this is turning out to be really complex. So the simpler, the better. Let's give that just a position, a quadrant. And a direction. Should give us all the information we need. So takes a V3I. What's up, Akuma? Welcome, man. V3I, position, quadrant, direction. And I'll make another convenience method too. It takes just X and Y. There, simple. Nice boogie. Yeah. Well, good, dude. Man, it sucks that that happened with your project. But at least you're at the point now where you're learning a lesson from it, you know, because that's how you can take anything, any negative situation. I mean, I'm philosophizing here, but, you know, any negative situation could be a positive if you just simply see it that way. And one simple way to take any negative situation and make it positive is to learn from it. So good job, man. It's tough. It's tough to learn from your mistakes. That's why it takes so long for us humans to do that. Yeah, I know, man. That's crazy. Git, man. Git repo. Git repos. Any kind of repo. Okay, so now find edges squared takes a vector of edges. And yeah, I think this is all this is going to need right here. Oh, yeah. I think that, yeah. I'm scared to delete this whole method yet, but I'm going to try commenting it out for now and finding edges simply like this, but this time find edges squared. This is this style. Find edges squared is not going to use the is edge function. It's going to roll its own basically. I know, right? Yeah. Yeah. That's kind of how I am right now. I wish I was already at the point where this whole code was just way more simple, but it's going to take a minute. So we've got, okay, so if we want to go, we want to loop over every single position on the whole map. Look for the style. Count the openings. Make sure there's zero. Go over every single direction. This needs to be every single quadrant. No, yeah, this needs, okay, this needs to be, there's only two directions. Man, this is such a crazy loop. Print I equals zero. I is less than two. I plus plus. The quadrant for this. Yeah, take a 5-minute nap for sure. Let the force flow. Yeah, well, or you could say your issue was that you didn't have a Git repo that you could have just restored your files from. If you had a Git repo, you'd be all good right now. Because what having a Git repository or any kind of source control repository is gonna let you go back in time and see what you changed that day and go, oh, whoops, I don't want to do that. Undo it. You know, it's very, you got to have that in your, that tool in your arsenal, man, the source control. All right, so if we haven't traversed, this quadrant, this is still XY, quadrant D plus I. And so this styles. Yes. Hey, what's up, Ferg? Okay, this is simple enough to kind of abstract out here. You can specify an index x, y, y there. Add a direction. Oh man, I got an idea. I got an idea for a function that would really help these adders out. Make it easier. Easier, always easier. What's up, Ferg? GitLab. Oh, sweet, really? Open source GitHub, like? Awesome. All right, so breaking it down to its basics, add dir d to an x, return the x. And this is add dir y. This will make things so much easier. I'm gonna do the same thing for quadrants. Quadrants should be able to do the same thing. So now I don't have to like instantiate a variable. I can more easily use these functions in other places without having to be encumbered. This is in X, in Y, grad quadrant Y, at Durex. Hey, what's up, Clock? Ahoy, man. Ahoy. Custom implementation of a continuous integration system. What's a continuous integration system? Oh, it has Travis? Oh, that's awesome. Oh, crap, dude. I should do that too. Yeah, so it runs tests just like Travis. Cool. What's up, J2? Welcome to stream. For people that are just joining, I'm making it so the overworld is going to be divided into four different sub mazes. So basically, the entire green area here will be its own maze with perhaps gates, like three or four gates coming in and out of it. Same thing with like the sand and these mountainous areas. These will be separate mazes with gates allowing access into that area. So it's really gonna add a very interesting element to the overworld. Whoops, D equals K west, turn X minus one. X plus one, return X. Format C. All right, yeah, these convenience methods are going to be really handy. Interesting art, huh? What's that? Oh, cool. Looks very Zelda-y. Nice, futuristic Link. Sweet. I know, right? Sorry about that. Yeah, I got a second display going today. Well, I got an iPad. Yeah. And so hopefully the settings are working okay for you guys. I'm experimenting with this, you know. I don't know if this is the way I'll actually keep on streaming with the iPad here. But it's kind of, I don't know. You guys tell me, how do you like this? How do you like having the chat window open the whole time and all that? Oh, and let me run the game and oh, the game's broken right now, but it's not gonna run the actual game. But there, what do you see with, like that? Does that show you the chat window on top of this the whole time? Probably does. Too bad I can't tell. But yeah, let me know how you guys like that, or if you don't like it, or whatever. So southwest, northwest are both west. Southeast, northeast are both east. Chat stays. All right. So why we want southwest, southeast? Northwest, northeast. Right, so I just did all that to make something simpler. Let's double check this. Hold on. Southwest, south, northwest. Yep. Southeast, northeast. Yep. Southwest, southeast. Yep. Northwest, northeast. Yeah, that looks good. You like the new way of interacting with Xcode? Oh, right. Oh, do you mean like control open and all that? Yeah. Dude, this is so much better. If anybody's, yeah. I did this a while ago, but it's changed the way I understand Xcode so much. And I basically just simplified the whole project and I created some permanent tabs. You just click on it, you can double click on a tab, name it. And then I edited all my behaviors and stuff. So all my behaviors are really customed out and they're just like they open up the tab that I wanted the whole time. And then to quickly go from any file, there's a quick open command, and I map that to command O. So it's just the regular file open command opens up this, because this is so dope. I never knew about this Xcode feature, but it's called the find quickly thing or something like that. What is it? Is it an actual? No, it's open quickly. Yeah, open quickly. That's the command that I'm running basically to open the files. And not only can you open files really quickly, but you can do partial names. So let's say I wanted to open the render system. I can just type in RESY and it opens up my and it's automatically knows the open render system. And if I wanted the dot H, I just press down once. It can also do functions too. Like let's say I wanted to skip all the way to the function called moodjib. There's a function called moodjib and it works. Or I could just call moji, the same kind of thing. So very smart. And I can't believe this feature is not. Oh, is it very Sublime-esque? Okay. Yeah. If anybody's using Xcode, there's some stuff that really ought to help your productivity. All right. So yeah, I can now that this is like this, I can rewrite the isEdge function. I can go this has styles. Instead of XX, I can go add dir X. The direction we're heading in is D. The X is just X. Here we add dir Y, D, Y. And the styles are next style. Possible the pushback. Yeah, you're welcome, man. So we're gonna push back a new edge now. This is gonna be an edge with XY quadrant Q, or quadrant is D plus I. And the direction is D. There. This is a totally different way of doing this method, but I think this is kind of cutting into the core of how it should have been. And I think I can actually get rid of find edges now. In fact, let's do that. Let's try it out. Let's create another vector. This time we'll create a vector of edges. We'll call this one possible 2 for now. And I'm just going to call find edges squared with possible 2. And yeah, break there. Let's see what happens. Hey, what's up, Pedro? Welcome to welcome to today's stream, man. Howdy. Oh no, your car battery died? Boogie's like, nice. It lived a prospered life. It's gone to battery heaven now. There's other batteries there. Some of the batteries are like really sexy. There's like 72 virgin batteries that the battery can get it on with. It's amazing, dude. It's battery heaven. All right, what happened? Did it work? Let's see. Possible 2 is sized to 18. Possible 2 is going to be kind of different. Okay, so 100 is one of the first ones. Well, let's look at the map. Yeah, 100. This one should have 1, 2, 3, 4 different gates all on 100. Great. Oh, wait. We don't have these. Oh, wait. Is that right? Yeah, 100 should have 4 gates. Vok, what's up, man? What's been happening? Lots. Yeah. Wow. I don't remember when you were here last, but you should check out the latest video. What's the trailer link again? The video will really help you see what's been new, what's new lately. Is it trailer? Oh yes. Thank you, Bonfu. You're so awesome. Bonfu is the dopest thing ever. Yeah, there you go. Check out that. Yeah, it's September. All right. Yeah, lots of change since September. Check out that video. It should show a little. Basically, diagonal movement. More items. Yeah. Now, right today, I'm working on the overworld. So my goal for today is to lock off all these different colored areas into separate mazes. So this green area will have its own maze with gates. The dark green area have its own maze and stuff. All right, so this did not succeed. It got 2 of the quadrants that it should have had, but it didn't do the... Here, let's set the breakpoint back up here. So on the second retry. Yeah. Oh, yeah. The fluid animations. I forgot about that. Yeah. More awesome explosions. Right. Oh yeah, the enemies. There's lots of new enemies. These fant guys look like elephants. There's like porcupine guys that look like Bob Ross sort of. There's these bouncy guys. There's this boss fight at the very beginning of the game now. Nice. Could I actually do this right now? I broke. I'm in a state where I can't. I'm so broken. It's got more PC warriors. Yeah, I can't really show the explosion of the sword boss right now because I'm gonna have to unroll a bunch of code to get the game compiling like that again. So maybe later on in this stream, I can get to the point where I can be like, okay, now I can actually compile it and show the game. Sorry about that, but today's kind of, I'm deep in some code right now. I don't want to get out of this depth. All right, cool, man. Oh yeah, the boss explosion is in the trailer. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, the new trailer has that. Cool. All right. Okay, so what I'm doing now is I'm working on this find edges squared function. It gave me two possible values that were correct, but then this one area did not have the other two areas. For example, what I'm looking at is this very first area right here, this first green area. It should have a possible edge right there, a possible edge there, a possible edge there, and then one there too. So this should be four edges. Yeah, cheers, man. So I'm gonna step into this method and understand it. So now we're at x1, y0. We're at the right area. We're gonna loop over every single direction. So that's gonna be like, it's gonna loop over south, looking at both of those. Looping over west, looking at two of those. Every direction has two different possibilities. So south. Oh. It breaks. No wonder. Gosh, when you just stop and like actually debug your code, it can be really obvious what's going wrong. So yeah, this thing shouldn't break. This needs to look at every edge, push them all back if they're successful. Yeah. All right, let's run that again and maybe just step over and hope it works. Come on, work this time. Work it accurately. Return all the directions that I want. Work perfectly. Find edges squared. Okay, possible two. This thing should have four parts of it. Yes, look at this. Four. Right on. The next one should be 13, 0. Yeah. Bam. We got it. Okay, so this first area, 1, 0, 0. This thing has quadrant one, direction one, which is the southwest, west. Yeah, southwest, west. This next thing is northwest, west. Yes. The next thing should be northwest, north. So northwest, north. That's correct. I wish these would show me. I think this can actually work like this if I go custom type. Whoa, that was annoying though. I wish it would show me that. K Northwest. But anyways, just translate for now. All right, Q3. I lost my track. Right, okay, quadrant two, direction two. That's north, yeah, northwest, north. Good. And then the next one should be northeast, north. Yeah, good. We got it. So now maze edge four is 13, 0, 0. Thirteen zero zero has two edges, three edges. Let's see how many edges should this have. This is 13, 0, 0. We should be able to cross three different areas right there. But not a fourth. Good. Okay, what's this? What are all these three? Just to check. We've got quadrant, northwest, north. Yeah, northwest, north, northeast, north, northeast, north. Good. And then this one should be northeast, east. Yeah, beautiful. Okay, these are all working. Let's check something hard. Like this one would be difficult. these two actually are actually pretty important and difficult ones, and they should be right at the end. This one should have nothing because it has an opening. This one should have three openings or three edges. This should be the last ones. Man, now that these are V3 eyes, I almost want to make them not V3 eyes because they're more difficult to debug. But anyways, okay, there's 12, 2, yeah, there's only three. Yeah, good, there's three of them. We have got quadrant, north, east, north. Northeast, north, yay! Northeast, east, and north. Or this is south, southeast, east. All right, I'm satisfied. What's up, Soldner? No, I'm definitely not hard coding a 2D map here. I'm doing something a lot more dynamically coding than that. Check this out. What I'm doing is I'm creating a sub maze. So this is the maze generator before it goes and adds in the whole maze. You can see the white lines right here are going to be pieces of the maze. But this is the phase before that even happens. So what I want to do now is separate out the overworld into several different sub mazes. So the whole green area will have its own maze, the yellow will have its own maze, this mountain will have its own maze, this dark green one will have its own maze. And there'll be gates between them. So there might be a gate here, here, and here, for example, out of the green area into the dark green area. And that's what I'm working on. Okay, so now that we've got this whole find edges squared function working and working well, I'm gonna go ahead and let go of this method. Nah, I might need that. Anyways, I could think I might be able to let go of this method now. Find edges. So I don't need the regular edges or the old edges anymore. And I think I'm actually going to rechange these edges, this struct edge, into being a XY. Make it a little simpler. Oh, awesome, man. Oh, welcome to the channel, man. Yeah, so sorry. When I'm normally streaming, I do a lot of pixel art, and I also play the game a lot more. But today's stream is going to be really code heavy because I'm working on a really, really code type of thing, and I'm probably not going to be playing the game at all today's stream. So, because I'm deep in the code right now, deep in it. Yeah, and now we don't even need the isEdge function. Hello, man. All right, we're already using the one edge constructor, which works there for XY. Now I should run, be able to run it again and still get the same results from this find edges function. Looks like we lost scope right there. Damn. All right. So I'm just verifying that this function now works. Find edges squared. What do we get? Possible. We got 31 different areas. The first area, 1, 0, should have 4 different edges. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. This area 13, 0 should have 3 different edges. It does. The last areas. We should have 3 different ones at 7, 3. Yep. Good. Okay. Everything's working fine. All right, this is coming along well. This is a really difficult piece of code here. I spent hours on this last night. But it's because I wrote these functions and things got a little bit out of hand with. I didn't write them in a very clear state of mind, or you know what I mean. Sometimes it takes you 2 or 3 times to refactor a bunch of code until it gets simple. That's what I'm doing right now. Choose gates. All right, we're on to choose gates now. Choose gates is going to be a hell of a lot easier because it now uses this edge format. So you can place them into chosen. Yeah. And take the possible variable. We need a number that we're going to get out. So possible is possible for each one of these in the possible size. What's up, BLJ? All right, so I need to adjust minimum distance. Donger, this really depends on your game and what engine you're using. If your engine is already a cross-platform game engine, then it should be pretty easy. But there's still a lot of testing work on every platform you ever write for, so it doesn't matter. The porting part, the actual porting part, the writing the code to port your game, if you're using a cross-platform engine, that part is relatively easy, but the hard part is testing it. So you got to go and, you know, spend all the time to test to make sure your game runs well on that other platform. That's the time-consuming part usually, because today most game engines are already cross-platform. And if you're using a game engine right now that's not cross-platform, I would honestly recommend you think about using an engine that is cross-platform, because you're just kind of, you're doing yourself a big disservice to limit yourself to one platform, I think. But it all depends on your game and everything. Yeah, there are companies out there. Do some searching. I don't know how. I'm not sure how to find them or whatever, but I know there's companies out there, especially there's freelancers out there that'll do that kind of thing. So if maybe you want to look at Elance or whatever Elance changed into. What's the new website or whatever? That might be a good way to hire somebody on an hourly basis to test your game for you. Unless you can find a company. Maybe there are companies. I don't know. I'm not exactly sure. So we're going to loop over every one of these possible things. We're going to delete all. Yeah, this still works. It.x, it.y, less than minimum distance. Wait a minute. This it actually has a quadrant. So going over what elements to erase, we need to do a vector to Oh man, this one actually, I'm starting to think this might actually have been a bad way to do it. I might need to actually change from x to x2 instead. Or maybe store both. Yeah, screw that. I might as well just put the x2 in and the x in. This is supposed to be easy, right? So once we've got the X and the Y, you say add dir given X and Y and a direction. X out is X2, Y out is Y2. There. Easy enough. Hey, what's up, Peen Wally? Welcome, man. Welcome to the stream. I'm working on subdividing the overworld into four different, distinct, separate mazes. And it's tricky, but it's going. It's almost getting there. I'm almost to the point where I'm going to place a gate. Multiple different gates going from one area to another. Yeah, friends testing. There you go. That's pretty cost effective, right? Gotta love that. So P was a really bad name for that. That should be edge, auto edge. The position, that can now be P. This is going to be edge.x2. This is edge.y2. We're pushing back chosen. Now we're pushing back to the edge, yeah. Chosen.pushback edge. And now we're going to delete all the other elements that are near that edge. So all we need is it2.x2, it2.y2 is less than minimum distance, which should still be okay. What's wrong with that? It, b3i, oh. Erase some, this is an edge now, const edge. Oh, and this is now all right, cool. Yeah, see, that's another way too. Beetle J, why do you say you need money to get on Greenlight? Are you talking about the $100 fee? Okay, well, I'm ready to test this method out. I'm gonna step through it. It's got a world retry count. This is okay. I'm gonna put that right above or past that. So ready to just try out choose gates function. Chosen possible. This should still compile. If it does, I'll run it. All right. I'm stepping into the choose gates method. It's going to clear out the chosen array, which should be empty anyways. There should be 31 possible, possible a gates from this. So basically this generator has figured out that there's 31 different areas that can be possible gates. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You get the point. There's a bunch. There's 31 of those around here. In fact, let's just count that to make sure. So that was 8. Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. 31. Perfect. Cool. Hey, what's up, Brandon Dyer? Welcome, man. I'm upgrading the overworld generator today. So, okay, this is gonna pick four different, or n, yeah, n is four. So it's gonna pick four different gates. It's gonna make sure they're out all a minimum distance away from each other. What's that minimum distance gonna be? 27 for this. So that's possible dot size over float n. So possible dot size is 31 divided by 4 is 7.75, truncating that down to 7, squaring it, it's 49, and subtracting 1. I guess that's wrong. Oh, I was supposed to square it, not cube it. True, true. Okay, let's see this again now that I've fixed that minimum distance. Okay, stepping into the choose gates function again. This time we've got a minimum distance of 13. Is that right? Should have been 7 squared. Oh, 7 squared is 14 minus 1. Yeah, it's 13. Okay, so the minimum distance between anything should be 13. Let's see if that's right though. I is less than n, possible size greater than 0. Index, choose one at random, grab the edge, create a position, push back the edge as chosen, erase all elements. No, that just erased every single element. Damn. Okay, let's run that again. Let's set a breakpoint here inside that lambda. All right, this is making this hard to debug as this anonymous lambda function. So I'm going to make this an actual named lambda function. Auto, we're going to call this doErase equals that. And this is small enough to put on one line now. No. Keep it on two lines so it's easier to debug. And you should be able to just call doErase here without any parentheses or whatever. Oh yeah, we're good. Building good. All right, this time we're breaking. Let's do erase method. And I want to disable it for now. Turn on again. Step in here. Enable this again. Run to that. Okay, so what are we trying to, oh man, should have paid attention to what edge got chosen. Oh yeah, the edge that got chosen is 3, 2, which is actually then the south, wait, y is 2, that's the second one up, the third one over. That's second. Yeah, that's right here. Is that right? X is 3. That would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2. Interesting. You put the edge there. Brandon Dyer, does my AI use machine learning? No, not yet. I might add that. That'd be pretty cool. Machine learning is sweet. All right, so this iterator is pointing to x1, 0, x2, 0, 0, quadrant 1. Yeah, this is all good. Possible index, though, that got chosen. I'm wondering about that. So the distance it gets. Oh my god, gotta make this easier to debug. So what this is, it's always easier to debug if you've got the variable. We can make this faster if I wanted to by using different, by using a direct distance function right there rather than using constructing two vectors. But that's not too necessary at this point to make it super fast. So here, once again, we got to disable this breakpoint. Step into this method. I want to see this first chosen edge. What is this edge? It's chosen x4, 2, x2, 3, 2. That's wrong. Well, well, well. Oh yeah, not add dir. This is get x2, y2. Big difference. This takes the x, y direction, squares the x to y2 to get those, and then adds the direction after that. Actually, it's quadrant we want, not direction. Yeah, let's see that again. Hey, what's up, Froom? Okay, so what I need to do is look at all these possibles again and make sure their x2 and y2s are coming out all right. So this is x2s. Yeah, that one's good. This is quadrant one. Yeah, okay, that's right. So the next thing is xy. Quadrant two is the 0, 1, 2. That's northwest. So we should have x is 2, y is 1. Good. Let's get to something. Actually, I'll look at every one of the ones in here. 1, 0, x2, or quadrant 2. Once again, this is the exact same x2, y2 as before. This one's quadrant 3, which is northeast. And that gives it x2 is 3 and y2 is 1. Yeah, that one's okay too. Let's get on all the way to the end where it's doing the 7 threes. So look at 7-3, quadrant 0 would be the south east. So 7 squared would be 14, plus 1 would be south, yeah, 15. And 0, so 3 squared would be 6. Yeah. Okay, well that's fixed now. So now I can step into this method, choose gates again. And this time we should be able to calculate distances between edges much better. So this time we've got an edge. The edge that's chosen is 4, 2. Good, it's the same chosen one. Hello, Sunset Kite. Welcome to the stream, man. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome to the crazy stream. Sorry, it's a mostly programming day. I do pixel art and I do play this game often. This is not yet what the game looks like, but I'm working mostly on code today. I'm really deep in it, so I can't really stop and play the game at this point. Yeah, we got edge 4-2. It's x2, y2, quadrant 2, dir 1. So we're going to be at 4-2 in the quadrant 2, which is northwest, heading west, northwest, west. And this is 4-2. So on the map, that is actually 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2. This is the area we're talking about. And the quadrant we're looking at is northwest. The direction is west. So this is the gate that we're talking about right there. Yeah, totally. Get yourself a C++ game engine. The engine I'm using here is called Cocos 2DX. Pizza night, yes. All right, dude, have fun, man. Thanks, Pedro. Yeah. Unreal, for sure. That's a good one. Pizza, we all want it. Dude, oh man, it makes me so hungry right now for pizza. Okay, now we're gonna go and do erase all these. We're gonna look at every single element, run it to there. Current iterator, we're looking at 1, 0. The distance is 7.8. All right. I think this is okay now. Seven point two is less than min dist. This minimum distance might need to be smaller, but other than that, I think this is working okay. which is awesome. We've gotten rid of three methods so far. So now, we'll set another breakpoint here, or the variable there, so we can step over that. Man, I am hungry for pizza all of a sudden. Dang. Pizza? Oh. Choose gates. Let's see what happens. What do we get? What do we get? Return false. You couldn't find them? Oh, you know what? It might not have worked. Step in again. Yeah, that definitely messed it up. So now there's only 12 possible gates left because we chose this area. What are the 12 gates that are left then? Oh, I guess it shouldn't square. No, yeah, it shouldn't square this minimum distance. That makes sense. Should be the minimum distance should be like 7 or whatever for this. Let's try that. Man, thank you guys. I gotta say thank you right now. Thanks for joining the stream. Thanks for supporting me in the stream. Thanks for liking this game. Dude, I'm glad we found each other. Boogie, Pedro, Mars of Power, PETA, everybody. Everybody that used to be on the stream too. Brad, Serious Creeper, all the other folks. Steve Tranby, Doc. Man, I love you all. You're great people. Thanks for supporting this game. Yeah, of course. I mean, seriously, I've been developing this game for 260 days live, and it would suck if there wasn't if nobody liked this game. It would really suck. Arcane, what's up? I just had to say that. Why? Yeah, thanks, guys. Yeah, I really do appreciate you guys, though. Do they have a Best Twitch Award? See what happens that time. Did it work? Oh, it did. Did it choose? Okay, I think it just actually worked. Oh my god. Yes, look, it chose 4 different gates. Boom. No idea. We need to start it. There will eventually be. Emily is away, is said. Good. We picked 4 different edges. Oh man, this. Oh yes. Oh my god, this is great. Now that we've chosen, okay, choose gates works. Now we're gonna work on place gates. There's no need for find edges squared. We already did that. Oh man, I'm so glad I rewrote this code. It was tough, but Doc, no way! What's up, Doc? I was just talking about you, man. I was just saying thank you. That's really all I was saying. Welcome, Doc. I hope you're doing good, man. What I'm working on today is I'm working on the overworld generator again. And this time I'm at version 9 or whatever of the overworld generator. And I'm making it so the green area is its own sub-maze. And the dark green area is also its own sub-maze. And every one of these different huge sections, there's four main sections of the overworld. They all have their own maze. And then they all have their own gates. So, like, for example, the green area here would have, like, three different gates. Like, maybe there's a gate there, there, and there, or whatever. So that's what I'm working on. Kind of complicated, but getting more simple. Okay, we've got the chosen edges, the traversal types. We've got this style. We've also got next style. Wait, do we even need next style anymore? No, we don't need this style or next style because we already chose the gates. Oh man, this is nice. I love it when code falls away. There. What happened to this? Oh, look, we've been streaming the whole time. No drops. Wait, 400 drops, but. Struggling without internet, what? No way. Yeah, I mean, I'm deep into the code today. Yeah, dude, you just storm took out the internet for your house? Oh, that must have been a crazy storm. Possible? No longer needed. Find edges squared? No longer needed. That's no longer needed. Choice? Yes, this is good. We're going to go... Oh, we already know what choice is. Choice is P. Yeah, P.x. Okay, choice up first was... Yeah, right? Choice up first was the quadrant. So that would be... P.q. Oh, we already have the x2, y2. Oh, man. This is so much easier. P.x2, P.y2. Choice.second, that was the P.d. Choice.second again, P.d. There we go, and then the choice that second here is once again P.d plus 2. Yeah, and since this is guaranteed to work, we don't need to track how many were placed, and we don't need to say return false or whatever. We might as well do that too. Oops. There. So we're setting open squared on the current gate, the current edge, and then it goes to the next edge. So, for example, what we're doing here is if we're setting a gate open right here, we're going to be setting this edge right here to be open. This white, that will have a white area right there, and it will also have a white area right there. And that will complete this as an open edge. And so we're setting open squared here. and we're setting open square there. And then we're marking the first area as a gate area. Just neighbors, man. Just the neighbors. Okay, I think this is gonna work. Let's try it. If this does work, we'll have some gates finally. Okay, so this time we're placing gates and we're giving it the the chosen array. We don't need style types. We don't need the desk either. Let's get rid of that. Yeah. Oh, I love when code falls away. In fact, I'm ready to get rid of these old ones too. I think. Wait, no. No, we're almost there. Almost ready to delete that other stuff. Let's see if this works. In fact, I'm gonna try it without the Y. Oh wait, that doesn't work. Oh, void, of course. There, you don't need to check place gates anymore. Choose gates, place gates, mark edges, and we'll be done. This is quite the algorithm. Yeah! Oh! It worked. Cool. All right, we got gates started up. So all those little white edges are successfully places where those are going to be the exits from the green area into the dark green area. And it's marked those areas with the G flag for gate. And all those edges are working. Yeah, dude, that's huge. Awesome. And now we just need to mark edges. Yeah, BC Warrior did that. Bafu. So the rest of this is pretty simple. All we need to do is look at all the edges. The original edges. And see if they haven't already have been traversed. Oh my God. Okay, I'm definitely gonna delete this code now. This is not needed. Yeah, get rid of that. Get rid of this. Yes, definitely that feeling when you solve something, for sure. Okay, now we're just down to marking edges, so. Let's take a screenshot of what we got so far, and that way I can keep referencing that image instead in the Photoshop. So cool. We got that part. Wait, we don't need this open anymore. Don't need that. Don't need that. Cool. All right, here's what we're working with now. All right. So yeah, the goal now is to go and fill in the edges. So for example, this one right here needs something. It needs a white area right there and there so that the maze doesn't go and allow itself to get outside. So basically every one of these edges now needs to be filled in somehow so that the maze generator knows it shouldn't traverse over that certain section. So it and it can be filled multiple different ways. Like this quadrant right here basically needs to be filled somehow. So there needs to be a line going there or there or there, but not there. So every one of these edges needs that. The safe bet is to go interior. So let's mark edges with possible. Yeah, just possible. We don't need to pass style types. Good. Now we're going to loop over every single edge and choose. We're going to look at every. Oh yeah, we can simply just make a vector for each edge that has all the possible quadrants. Oops. Possible quadrants. No, possible just possible directions. Yeah, so we're gonna get a vector of dirs possible. Each time we run this loop, we're gonna clear the possible array and loop over all dirs for each dir d. If d is not equal to p dot d. Oh, why am I calling this p? It should be more like I. If I is not equal to p dot d, then we've got this as a possible direction to head in. Possible pushback d. And also we need to check, wait, if I dot d is not equal to d. And if there's no openings, count openings squared inside this position, which is I dot x2, I dot y2. We've got no openings whatsoever in the current quadrant, and that's yeah. So now if the possible array is empty, then we're going to continue this loop. So we're not going to break out of the whole function or whatever. We're just going to count it as, all right, if I couldn't find any possible directions, like for example, this, if we're at that quadrant right there, none of those are going to be possible because we already set a gate there. So we should skip over those. But now that this is possible, we can choose one at random. And just set it. If index equals drandf, no, just drand is, wait. Now we use this thing's this get rand. Yeah, that'll work. And mod that by possible dot size. There, now we got an index, and now we're so we've chosen an index. We got that means that we can have a direction. The direction is possible index. And all we got to do is set open squared. What's my favorite thing to code in this game? So far, man, that's a tough choice. Probably the AI. I mean, I'm not even really coding AI anymore. I'm more of like doing data-driven AI, but still, I guess the AI, because it's really rewarding to see your things come to life, and AI is just does that. Set open squared I dot x two, I dot y two. What was paired up first? Set open squares direction and open. What's that? Oh, I had quadrant and dir, but that was x. Okay, yeah, so we got dir is just out d. True. Think this might work. Good choice. All right. I don't know if that will work or not, but I'm gonna run it without even breaking to see if it does. Oh yeah, cool. Looks like it did. All right, yeah, so every single area now that is not a gate has some sort of path. It's randomly selected, and it's just made sure to not face towards the gated direction. But that did, oh, that will be a problem. That could be a problem in some areas. For example, if this bottom left. This is one potential problem point. Any one of these corners like this. Why is that eating the CPU like crazy? Anyways, like this guy right here in this corner. This corner has two different. Oh, it uses the same rand index. Oh, smart. No wonder it works. Okay, no, there's no problem. Oh wait, no, the rand index. Oh no. The rand index is, yeah, it's the same rand index, but it's could be a different direction. So what the potential problem is here is that if it's working on that edge right there, that quadrant going east, then it could possibly choose to put a direction going north. Okay, I know what to do. Basically, it needs to choose a direction that is within the same area. So if its direction faces outward at all, it needs to be an interior direction, basically. I take care of all of the important randomness with the world generation at the very beginning. So the very beginning of the world generator. It goes and it picks like thousands of random numbers that it's going to use for the world generator, and then it uses those inside the class. So it's already pre-picked its random numbers, and that just keeps it from using too many of the other deterministic random numbers, just to keep everything deterministic, basically. So this is the last part. Mark edges. We need to make sure that any direction is an interior direction, or else, or yeah, it needs to be an interior direction to this style though. You know, I kind of want to let this thing run wild and see what happens. Let's do it. I'm going to disable this code, which was stopping the generator from running, and let it run. Let's see what happens. Let's see if it contains the maze within the green area. Oh, it just retried a million times. 200, yeah, I retried 255 times and then it broke. What were all those retries? Hey, what's up, Arcor? How you doing, man? It's been a while, dude. I hope you're doing good. 92 stranded areas. Unable to place 4 from light areas. 87 stranded areas. There's a lot of stranded areas here. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I think I know what's going wrong. That needs to be able to hook up to the rest of the maze. Busy with school? Right on. How's school going? Sweet, dude. Cool. C sharp. Does that mean you have to develop on Windows for that? Okay, before we let this run wild, before we mark edges, I think the gates that are placed. Nice, right on. Cool, man. All right, I gotta remember how the generator works. Cause either this one here, this little section of the maze needs to not be there, or this one needs to not be there in order. For the maze generator to hook itself up. Oh, you know what? In fact, I think it's the one on the outside, because if you look at these are all ready to go. Yeah, it needs to do it inside its current area and then stop. So that allows it to hook up later. So these, I need to chop off these edges going that way and that. I need to chop off all those edges. So not setting that one, not setting the open square going opposite. There we go. Cool. Yeah, now we've got a couple mini edges ready to go. The rest are marked randomly. Now let's try letting the generator run. It did it. It broke again. Well, it's getting closer, but it's still not working for some reason. Last night this was working, but last night the code wasn't really written that well. It looks like the maze generator just kind of gave up. The dirty code always works better, doesn't it? What the hell? What's up with that? I'm trying to imagine how this maze would have got generated and then died, right? Basically, the maze generator tried 255 times to make this world, and then it failed every time. So it was like, I gave up. And it just left us with this imperfect overworld here. I'm thinking what's going on is it's generating the maze, and then it gets totally stuck inside, and so it never goes outside. Oh. Actually, what might need to happen is it needs to not even I think this might be it, where it doesn't even place gates. All it does is set a flag for the gate. And then it just needs to make sure when it marks the edges that it doesn't mark a chosen edge. Or I could remove chosen from possible. Remove chosen. This doesn't need to capture find edges square anymore. All right, so we're gonna have a const vector of edges. Oh wait, no, this is a vector of edges. And a const vector of edges. To remove. So I'm going to loop over every edge and then loop over every other remove edge and see if it has it. And if so, remove it. So if it x2 equals I, ix2, basically if this is the same edge, it'd be better if I just wrote a operator equals here. There we go. So now we got op equals for edges. So if it, if indirection of it equals I, do remove equals true and break. Do remove it equals edges dot erase it else plus plus it. And I do want to set a breakpoint again. After we place gates, I want to remove. What did I call this? Remove chosen. From possible. Yeah. All right. Okay, we placed all the gates. We've got four different gates it chose. We should have four. Let's see. Yeah, four different things it chose. Possible size 31. One of the possible is 4-2. So basically after we remove chosen. Yeah, cool. So we went down from 31 down to 27. Good. We removed those four elements. And now we can mark the edges with possible. And this that should allow more. Let's see if that works. In world, we're still doing, yeah, we're still generating the whole maze. Okay, if this did work, then we should have a nice looking maze again. Oh, yes. All right. We got a successful mazes again. But the one problem is it took 62 retries in order to get that maze. So there's obviously some problems. And it really has to do with those edges that I'm just kind of randomly throwing about. But let's see if it works. We should have four different places where you can go from the green area, the light green area, into the dark green area. And I'm seeing three. Yeah. Thanks, guys. I think I'm seeing three there. No, wait, one there. Let's like highlight these. What? Oh. Bob Fu. Yeah, Bob Fu. You got to meet Bob Fu. Arcor, you can type command. You know, Bob Fu is a command. Just do a, you know, exclamation point. Exclamation point Bob Fu. I don't know. You can't see me type anymore. Damn. But I'm typing exclamation point bot foo. Wait, did you see that? You can do exclamation point help and get all his commands. Boogie wrote him. Oh, but he doesn't repeat himself. He's smart. He's pretty cool. Yeah, he's not repeating himself to keep it so it's not all, you know, he's not gonna flood the chat or whatever. Yeah, there you go. Oh, there's the fourth one. Okay. So it put one gate here. It put a gate here and a gate there, which is, it shouldn't be doing that. Oh, and a gate there. Oh, wait. These other gates. We got to turn off some of these gates. These other gates should be all, never gets old. Yeah. The null video, right? Never, ever. Yeah, it's calm today. It's Thanksgiving week here. And also, I'm just working on code. Usually there's more people that watch when I'm making pixel art or whatever. The other bit, where does it K-flag gate. Yeah, let's turn that off for a while. So this is going to turn off all the other gates. Before, the way gates worked is it would, on every single level, it would put a gate outside it. And that's just, that's too obvious, you know. It needs to be smarter. So I'm going to remove all these gates that are outside levels. Let's see it again. We're probably going to still be at the same number of retries. Yeah, we're still at about 62. But it did generate the world a little differently that time. Man, I'm getting hungry. What time is it? I think it might be about that time, guys. Yeah. Oh, the stream just reset anyways. That was weird. Well, yeah. Good as time as any. So, yeah, I'm just about to shut the stream down today. But to recap, I've been working on getting it so it subdivides the world into four different sub-mazes. So the light green area will be its own maze, the dark green area will be a different maze, the yellow area will be a maze, same with the brown area. And each one of these separate mazes will have certain little entrances into it. And I've almost got it working where the green area is now its own maze. It only has like four different entrances or exits or whatever you want to call it. There's one there, there's one there, there's one here, and there's one there, but it's not working. So I need to keep on working on this this algorithm and stuff. Is Game Show worth it? Yeah, I think it is. At least on Mac. On Windows, I think you can get really good performance and you can get all your voice to be in sync and everything. The problem I always had with OBS is my voice wasn't in sync and I couldn't record system audio, and Game Show does both of those beautifully. So I'm liking it so far. And it records with using less CPU, and it records into the MP4 format and a bunch of other cool stuff. So it's a pretty rad program. It's very well put together. And it's made by Telestream, which they also make like screencasting software and stuff. So anyways. Yeah, that's it for today's stream. And yeah, once again, thank you, everybody. I really appreciate y'all. So I'm probably going to stream tomorrow. Yeah, it's a win. I'm probably going to stream tomorrow. Might not, because I'll be prepping to go travel and see family for Thanksgiving and stuff like that. So if I don't see you guys, happy Thanksgiving. But I might be here tomorrow. So Yeah. See you guys. Have a good night. Cheers, cheers.